workshop meeting this Wednesday, October 21st, 2015 at 6:03 p.m. Can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Palmeyer?
Here.
Trustee Chavez?
Here.
Trustee Clancy?
Here.
Trustee Richards?
Here.
Trustee McKrevitz?
Here.
Trustee Griffin?
Here.
Mayor Noak?
Here.
We have a quorum.
Very good. Trustee Palmeyer, will you lead us in the pledge?
Thank you. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible with liberty and justice for all.
Very good. Any changes? We're good then? Signs, and more signs. Mr. Rockwell. First, we have ordinance 151219, an ordinance approving a variance from the zoning ordinance regarding a signage for Maggot Glove and Safety Manufacturing Company. Mr. Rockwell, please.
Thank you. A lot of papers. Maggot Glove and Safety Manufacturing Company on 1300 Naperville Drive is represented by Neon Sign Company, requested a zoning variance for a package of signs and a wall signs for their new facility on the north side. The company purchased a building from Sharp Electronics in April of 2014 and been operating the village since that location since November of 2014. At the time, no temporary directional signs had been installed or any signs over the Sharp signs. And there's no wall sign on the building at all. The wall sign height is proposed to be, see if I could find it, is to be 9 feet, 8 inches, while the code allows 5 feet in the M1 district and was changed 3 years ago to allow it to be 5 feet. Their proposed wall sign is about 2 times the maximum height. As of September 2015, this village board approved a freestanding directional signs, making them bigger so they could be 6 feet tall with 12 square feet of total sign area. Maggie's is proposing 5 of these, 6.5 feet, not 6, and 20 square feet and not 12 on the directional signs to get you into their lot, back to their property. You can see it's very large and they're putting the directional signs along A, B, C, D. You can see them there. The maggot safety and work portion of their signs, you can see underneath it, is about 25%. According to the code, it's only about 10% they typically do. The Zoning Board of Appeals, I will call your attention, this was a Zoning Board of Appeals since they haven't met in 3 years. So the Zoning Board of Appeals reviewed the application on September 22nd, and they found the request to meet the standards in Section 159 and Ordinance 15129. I will spare you the supplemental standards, but these are the zoning standards that have to be met under the zoning board. And outlined in Section 159-172 regarding the standards, the development review team did not recommend approval because they could not prove a hardship. However, the Zoning Board of Appeals unanimously sent this recommendation to you to approve it. I don't recognize anybody here being from Maggot. Okay, so this is the sign.
Very good. This is a very reasonable request for a site of this nature. I mean, that's why we have a process to be able to allow to have unique sites. You know, if not every site has this many different entrances, this big, has employee entrances, it's receiving delivery, it's a big site with a lot of different things going on. So it's actually in our best interest to make sure that that traffic flows properly and safely on the site. So Maggot's been a great partner so far. This is not an unreasonable request for a site like this, in my opinion. So, but I'll let the board comments and questions from them. Trustee McKrevitz, please.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I just want to confirm, you've said already that the Zoning Board of Appeals did feel that they were okay with this, and that was something that they recommended to the board to go ahead and move forward with.
They did.
Okay. Was there any concerns? I didn't notice anything in the paperwork that we had with any concerns whatsoever.
I think, as the mayor suggested, they wanted to put it on the building. The one that had been there from Sharp was big. They wanted to match that, you know, with different codes. And then, as you can see on their property, as you're coming down Naperville Drive, they have several different parking lots, and they want people to know where they are. So it was safety concerns, and we weren't quite troubled by that.
I live up in that area, so I'm very familiar with the site, and I do agree, some of those signs are easily missed, and so it certainly makes sense to have better directional signs in that area. I just want to confirm that there were no issues that were brought up in the meetings.
No.
Okay. I appreciate that. Thank you.
Any other questions, comments? Trustee Richards, please.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. And if I'm not mistaken, and I, most of these signs are more different shape than what the prior tenant had, what Sharp had in there. I mean, some of them are, yes, they're beyond the code, but if I'm not mistaken, it looks like they're just bigger by a small amount and different shape than some of the Sharp signs, so it's not that different from what the prior tenant had.
No, they're very tall.
Right.
But that's because most of the information they need is at the top of the sign instead of being at the bottom.
Right.
So, no, we didn't have, we could not recommend because we can't have, but if you want to overrule and say that that's what you want to do, that's fine too. And that's what the zoning board said.
Trustee Richards, I had met with Magid on this issue and went over it. Their biggest concern, especially the interior signs, was snow piling. You know, because they have so much, as the mayor talked about, internal roadways and so forth, and where do you pile the snow? And so, excuse me, they were concerned that, especially at these entrances of these so-called, you know, internal intersections, we got the pile of snow somewhere, so they wanted the signs to be a little bit higher than norm for that very reason, so that the vendors and so forth can get from A to B to C. That was their big reason why they felt that they wanted them a little bit taller. Yes.
Very good. Any other questions, comments? Thank you very much. Next, we'll have Ordinance 151220, Ordinance approving an amendment to a special use permit for a planned unit development for Ashley Furniture. Mr. Rockwell again, please.
Ashley Furniture, located at 1045 West Crossroads, here on your map, and represented by Aaron Hodgkin of the Hodgkin Group from California, is proposing changes to the planned unit development. Final development plan approved Ordinance 141148, Lot 1 of Bolt Park, including a request for a dynamic display freestanding sign. Ashley has been operating portions of the warehouse and distribution division since the beginning of this year and started in July with their sales of furniture from this location. Ashley is looking to attract customers from I-55 with large freestanding digital display signs. The sign is set back approximately 32 feet from Crossroads Parkway. This is a good idea. The sign's going to go, well, I got to get you. Sign's going to go here. It's about 30 feet to Crossroads and 300 feet to the center of the interstate. So now I don't have to read that part because I told you. The code allows for 40 feet tall. The ordinance that you just passed in August, September. 40 feet tall. Their proposal on the 14 foot that they requested was 35 feet tall. The sign area, the code allows 200 square feet, and Ashley's proposing 280 on option A. This is 40% larger than the maximum sign area along the monument sign along I-55. Dynamic display, we allowed it in the code to put it so they could have the dynamic, which for our purposes here, we'll just call the TV. Code allows 50%, so maximum would be 100, and Ashley's display is 14 by 14, which is 196, which is nearly double. Sign landscaping, the code requires 2 square feet of landscaping for every foot of sign, and Ashley's proposed sign would only have 560 square feet of sign landscaping, which is less than the minimum. And while it's understood that they're looking to attract customers, there's concern about the size of the sign. The larger signs that we have seen lately, Cracker Barrel, Country Inn Suites, those were built in 96. And recently you approved Wood Springs Suites that came in the Value Place. Their sign is 30 feet tall, 125 square feet, so it meets those requirements. The Planning and Zoning Commission held a public hearing October 13th, recommended approval of 15-220 with a reduction from the 14 by 14 to the 10 by 10 by 40, still meeting the corridor requirements and the recommendation of the Plan Commission meet the standards set forth on the ordinance, the sign section of the code, and the comparison is what we're looking at here. Sometimes we lose it on paper, so I did this for the Plan Commission, but the sign behind you on where you have your sign. That box is 14 feet wide where the, and then from the top to the bottom, I guess we built it for this purpose, from the top of the brick to the floor is 14 feet. So that's your sign that you're looking at, and then it's up two sections like that is 40 feet tall. So you can't do it in the dark and can't bring it in the room, but that's how this, you understand, these papers sometimes lose the dimension.
Very good.
And Eric, Aaron is here if you have any questions.
Great. Mr. Gullin, did you want to?
Yes, we had met with Ashley on several occasions on this. The last meeting, the mayor and I sat down and talked to Ashley and said, well, hey, let's come to some type of a solution, compromise. They wanted a larger video board than what's even there now, or dynamic sign. So we came to a compromise to say, hey, we will go with a 35-foot in height, but we will approve a little bit larger, or we will bring to the board a little bit larger type of dynamic display at 14 by 14. So that's why you see the difference from what code and versus what has been before you. Their biggest concern is we want to attract as much sales as possible to this location, because it's kind of a new venture to have this warehouse and a outlet sales, lack of a better term, but it looks like a store sales the way it's decorated inside, so it's no different than a store. And they wanted to get their brand and product out there as large and as more efficient as possible. So that's why they requested the 14 by 14. And again, the compromise was shrink it, widen it, and this is what we'll be bringing.
And then also the addition of the village of Romeoville on it, and I believe some usage on the rotation as well?
There will be usage on the rotation, correct.
Yeah, as part of that compromise. And I think, unfortunately, the final plans weren't, Trustee Richards, if I'm, correct me if I'm wrong, the planning zoning weren't ready for, didn't have this exact rendering at that time, correct?
Correct.
Yeah, so. But they're eager to try and get this going with construction and so forth. It is a little bit bigger than we've had before. There are much bigger ones in the corridor. The county's been approving even bigger ones. In fact, one just recently went up in an unincorporated portion of our territory that is much larger than this. This is a little unique again, because this is a hybrid store. It's not only a store, but it's also a distribution facility, which is a lot different than some of the other users on that corridor. The size of the building, as you saw from that rendering from the interstate, you could see why the larger digital display surface in comparison to that site and the size of the scope of the facility itself changes the dynamics quite a bit. So, you know, like Mr. Golden said, the original request was for a much even bigger sign. I'm glad they came down quite a bit, but obviously we'll see what the rest of the board thinks as well. Trustee Richard, you want to, because you were at the last meeting. So.
Yes, thank you, Mr. Mayor. Planning and zoning did a good job of looking this over and trying to look at it from all sides. Some very good comments and discussion. One of the things that was asked was, is this a standard for them? And it was brought out then that there really is no standard for a project like this, because it is unique with distribution center and retail development all in one building in a site that's on the interstate, but not in a retail area. They do have a similar project in California, and it's actually a 70-foot sign there. So we obviously weren't gonna go there. but you know, so what they felt they needed was actually, like you said, more than what they asked for. But this is a unique piece of property, because if you look at the size of the building, it's going to make it look like a big warehouse as you're driving down the interstate, so they want to attract business. Now, one of the concerns planning and zoning had is, what will all the neighbors want? I think this is a little unique in the fact that there's no doubt what Brunswick Zone does. There's no doubt what Cracker Barrel does. If you see a large Ashley warehouse-looking building in a industrial setting, you're going to assume it's their warehouse, not a store. So I think this does create some unique circumstances and some unique needs for them. I think it's a reasonable compromise to try and put something together that will attract business. One thing that Ashley did offer is they won't be selling advertisement. This will purely be their sign. So unlike a digital billboard on the side of the highway, it is for their use or our use, not for everything else. So, I think it's a reasonable compromise to put it at this size and height.
Now, we got the applicant here. Who's all here for him? We just have the one individual, or do we have multiple individuals? Mr. Rockwell, they were giving us estimates from Mr. Golden on increase in sales that they project on being able to potentially up to 2 million plus, something like that. They may get mad at me for saying that.
Yeah, I think Eric can help that, but when we first started, you gave them an incentive. We were in the area of 3 to 4 million, I think.
And they definitely are doing better than that, but they think they can even do better with this.
One of the things that, before Eric, go ahead, I just wanted to, what Trustee Richards was saying regarding uniqueness and, what our neighbors think. And absolutely, and we thought about that a lot. If a neighbor has $6-8 million worth of sales and sales tax coming back to the village, right? I mean, I'm sure that you guys would be willing to entertain something to help the sales, because we have a vetted interest in their success. So if it's a logistics, ex logistics who doesn't sell anything, well, there's no need for, why would we approve a sign like for ex logistics unless they're selling something that has value in retail to the village? And so that was kind of the thought process as well.
And I think you make an excellent point that somebody wants to come in and build a 400,000 plus building and have that much in sales, offices, and distribution all wrapped up into one. Certainly. In fact, actually, if somebody would like to say that, they can bring them by. We'd be happy to have a conversation with them soon.
And again, off an industrial piece of property, no less.
Yeah. But let's get some input from the rest of the board. Anyone else? Trustee Chavez?
As I said when it first came up, light it up.
I think we know where Trustee Chavez feels about this.
How soon can we get the sign up? How soon will the sign get up? I guess is my question.
How soon could you potentially get the sign up?
We'd still like to have the sign up before the end of the year, if possible. We'd need to submit for building permits, assuming that the project is approved. And our goal, though, would be to have it up by the end of the year.
Okay, good. Good luck.
Trustee
Chavez,
please.
Increases.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I think everybody on the board understands that I've always been one who has concerns with signs. For me, we have a planning commission for a reason. A lot of very intelligent people on that planning commission. They had excellent comments that I tend to agree with. I would find it very challenging for me to vote yes on the 14 by 14. I certainly would vote for the 10 by 10. And again, anybody who's seen me on the board here with signs, that's just a concern. I don't like to have a village that is too many bling signs all over the place. So it's important to me for things to be done in just I'm stretching for the words. Tasteful isn't necessarily the right word, but not something that's so big and to me, overly distracting. I think sales on a 10 by 10 sign isn't going to change anything if it's 14 by 14. I think people are going to see that it's Ashley Furniture. They're not going to misrepresent a 10 by 10 sign thinking that it's a warehouse, and a 14 by 14 isn't going to change their idea whether it's a warehouse or a sales. So from my aspect, I would certainly be able to support what the Planning and Zoning Commission supported, in so much as saying that a 10 by 10 sign, they're certainly happy with it, follows our ordinances. We just passed that ordinance. A lot of time and trouble was put together to develop that ordinance. So I would definitely side with the very intelligent people who made the recommendations on the Planning and Zoning Board. So I would find it difficult to vote for a 14 by 14. So.
Good. Anyone else?
Thank you. Actually, being that the situation is sort of unique, having the store or the outlet, however you want to phrase it, and the warehouse together, is rather an unusual setup, which are going to be more regular for people down the road later. But I think it's a tremendous idea, and I think the larger sign will attract more because they are going down the highway and you'll be able to see it better. So I'm in favor of it. So thank you.
Any other questions or comments? We'll move on. Ms. Rocco, we got to get a lot tonight. Ordinance 151222, ordinance approving a special use permit for planned unit development for present senior healing arts pavilion, outlot 10 of Romeoville Crossing. Please, Mr. Rocco.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. The Hams Company, represented here tonight by Mike Skoll, has proposed a present senior healing arts pavilion on outlot 10 here at the Romeoville Crossings in front of Sam's. The site will have multiple health uses, catering to seniors, including immediate care center, general health office, minor procedures, preventative health classes, and senior officers. The proposed presence health is 28,298 square feet on the 2.7 acre outlot and has three access points along the interior road. And one is through the, below is through the Firestone facility that's already there. Be an access point. There will be 102, I need to flip my clip off. There will be 122 stalls on the site and an agreement with Walmart Sam's Club. If you go back, see how close that is. They have an extra few parking spaces. So the presence has worked out a deal with Sam so that they could have their employees park there and still have plenty of parking places to share 34 minimum stalls with them. There will be a sidewalk along their eastern property line to allow that connects to Firestone and future outlot to the north to allow a walking on the Sam's Club property as well as that path. The building will be constructed of masonry. You've seen something similar, but it has changed. Construction of masonry culture stone, longboard or flat wood, outdoor paneling, and metal panel accents. There is a glass tower feature at the entrance to the health center with a, I didn't practice my French, so it's going to be a portico. The welcoming patients and guests. The proposed pavilion features arches with a multitude of windows around natural light. Signage. We had a lot of conversations with signage when they came through with you on the concept plans. They've submitted a sign package with a harmonious theme for the signs and materials and colors to match the primary buildings. And there are three wall signs. You're showing them here. They're hard to tell on the screen, but I think you know where they are. And there are two directional signs, one at the northernmost entrance and one at the southern entrance, because they split the building for uses on front and back. A typical decoration, a directional sign would be 3 foot tall and 6 foot square, and they worked with the village to decrease the size, but they're still larger than we would typically see, but they did decrease them by about 50%. Exceptions then would be, there's their signs. The rear parking lot setback is required to be 25 feet and they only have 19 and a half feet. The front yard setback is 30 feet and 60 feet is required there. The building would be allowed two wall signs and they're proposing the three wall signs. And the size of the directional size is an exception. Signs are 12 square feet, but typically the code maximum of 6 square feet. One wall sign is taller than the code allows by being 3 feet instead of the 3.5 that they're proposing. And longboard, the fake wood, is non-allowable material. It's newer material that the code does not address yet. In fact, we have another application using the same product that you'll talk about later tonight. And so we have no problem with that. The development review committee has reviewed this and had dated and contingent upon the completion of the license agreement with the village for where one of the signs is going to go and the agreement with Walmart Sam's for the parking. We're okay with that. And the planning and zoning held a public hearing October 13th and they recommended it contingent upon the same two requirements. We do have representatives from both Presence and their architecture firm here tonight as well as Hams if you have questions of me or them.
Very good. We've seen this one a few times. And I think actually, I think almost everybody here likes this building a little better than the first one, actually, even. So very excited to get this process going. I think if we get everything squared away, we have something scheduled maybe for later this week. And do you want to talk about your timeframe that you hope to do on the project?
Our goal would be to...
If you can come up the mic, that'd be great, just so I can hear you at home.
Our plan at this point would be to break ground this year, and this facility would be open towards the end of summer, early fall next year.
Very good. I really got to give a lot of credit to the hospital group and for all their efforts in reaching out to the community on this throughout the process. They did a lot of community outreach with the seniors and members of the community throughout the process. They took a lot of time on it. They came back actually with a better building than even the, which was a good building, the first one, don't get me wrong, an even better building. And it's just been a great partnership throughout, and we're just glad to finally get it underway and get them in here. So comments or questions from the board? Trustee Shedd.
Yeah, I'm looking over all this stuff. This will really service a lot of people. There's a lot of rooms here. I'm really looking forward to this. Something we really needed here on that part of town, and I'm really glad to see this here. I wish you guys best of luck.
Very good. Other questions or comments? Trustee Griffin, please.
Thank you, Mayor. Tell me about the sidewalk and how it's going to connect. I see a lot of people walking in the on the sides of Weber Road because of the lack of sidewalks there, and it concerns me because it's an accident waiting to happen. So,
you just knew I wanted to draw. That's a sidewalk.
Okay.
And that'll connect to the
existing sidewalk
fire
comes over into there, and we'll go. I haven't seen the absolute plan because we need to get onto the SAM site, but it'll go back into the SAM site. So that's how the sidewalks have been proposed, and engineering and our planning department have agreed with those. Does that answer your question?
Get the rest of them developed. We'll get them all done.
Yeah.
That'll be a good chunk of it right there. Other questions, comments? All right, we'll move on to the next one. Very good. We're excited to have you guys coming. Ordinance 151223, an ordinance approving the rezoning of territory to P1, public-private land, conservation district for the old Village Hall site. Mr. Rockwell, I think this is a lot of housekeeping here.
Yes, Ms. Palmiter's given me the bunt sign, so we've got to get out of here. So this is this is housekeeping. This property owned by the village for a very long time should be zoned as P1 public lands, and it is not. It's zoned residential and was built that way in the 60s with the idea that you want to sell it and do some other uses. Everybody's recommending you rezone it.
Yeah, I know a couple of members of the public showed up the hearing on this one, probably a little confused because they got letters. And actually, in this case, it couldn't go into a much more protective zoning, so it's kind of been that way forever. So just
we got more calls on this case than probably anyone.
Yeah, anything else tonight? More people calling.
Why are we
about
getting
this
letters? And most of them are comfortable.
We assure them that we are zoning it for what has actually been sitting right there for quite some time now. So, but it's good that we clarify that. So, but a lot of housekeeping. Any questions or comments on that one? Very good. It's funny that's the most caught questions though. Ordinance 151224, ordinance approving a minor amendment to a special use permit for a planned unit development for Brunswick Zone at 735 North Center Boulevard. Somebody else taking a little new look.
This is a little unique. Brunswick Zone was purchased last July by Bullmore Corporation out of New York. And they wanted to put their brands and get going and make this a different facility than it had been under Brunswick. So they started painting it. We suggested to them last Tuesday, they probably needed to look at the ordinances that when we approved, like we just did with other groups, we told them what paints, everything else to put on there. So before we could continue, I asked them to stop painting, come up with plans, which they did in about 24 hours. So that we could show you where they wanted to go. Their representatives are here from New York as well as locally with Tom, so that we could talk about what we want to do. So currently, I didn't put the current buildings up, and I think, Mary, you have one of these pictures. I have a couple of these if you want them in bright color, but they're the same as what you're seeing behind you. The front of the building currently was stopped, so they had the white stripe on there, and the tan color is still there. We asked that the tan color stay, go back, whichever is necessary. And their proposal then was, can we have this red pop with a red stripe and what you're seeing here on the backside, the machines are not doing what they wanted you to do. The machines are supposed to be showing that same tan color. It's a gray now, but they would go back to that same situation. And this, I think that's all we have for there. So both Justin Hack and Tom are here to discuss this, ask questions, but let's just say that it's a small goof and we got here very quickly.
And everybody got on it quickly. A lot of credit to everybody to get this just worked out real quick. Obviously, new owners, time to reinvest in the facility, a little bit of an update. I know, Tom, you're doing some various slight things inside as well. We redid the laser tag not too long ago that as well. So they're putting money back in it, which is great. They just have a little bit of a new look. So thoughts, comments? Tristan Kovitz, please.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I'm just looking for a clarification. On the summary page that is provided us,
all right.
It reads, you know, yada, 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 final development plan, approve ordinance, yada, 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 including a request for a dynamic display freestanding sign, and then it talks later about the painting and the gray and all of that. So when we vote, are we voting on just painting? Are we voting on a dynamic display sign? I was needing some clarification there.
I'm going to have them help you in a minute, but we could only do part of their issue. They did have more paint, more sign, more everything else on there, which is going to require a bigger process.
Okay.
But for you to let them get painting while it's 74 degrees, we could get them here tonight. So tonight's vote will be the paint scheme. If they want to come back and do anything else to the building and go through your regular process, we'll have that conversation.
Okay.
And I think their district manager wants you just to hop up here or over here and answer their question.
Hi.
Yeah.
Yes, so the original design, I know we weren't able to put it up there, but was quite a bit more aggressive, I think is probably the best word. And that does include some what would fall under the village ordinance as actual signage. So the discussion we had was, let's get the building to a point where we've got a little bit of our updated brand represented, and then we can go through the proper channels on the signage side. So my expectation is we'll be able to get back to this paint scheme before the weather turns, and then we'll be able to address the signage and anything else through the proper channels as we go through the winter.
Okay, very good. Because I just want to make sure that I'm not voting on dynamic display freestanding sign. I'm just voting on the paint scheme that you've shown here.
Correct. Yeah, we're just looking for approval on the paint scheme that's shown.
Okay, great. Yeah. Thank you.
It's good clarification. Anything else?
Mr. Mayor, Justin, you said something about doing other investments in the building. What were you talking about?
As a company, we've been investing a tremendous amount of capital back into our centers. So a lot of them have been getting updated furniture, a little bit more current flooring, things that'll make it a little more, we are a family entertainment center, and we want to be able to cater to all parts of the family. So I want it to be just as comfortable as a place for mom and dad to come in as for the kids to come in. So it's a little bit, you know, updated design within the furniture, and we do some kind of fun things with the floor that makes it a little bit more comfortable and current than what we're currently working with.
Very good. I think we like this part process a little better. Good. Any other questions or comments? Okay. Thank you.
If you indeed do approve anything like this scheme, we'll let them get back to painting as early as tomorrow. Good. If you don't, we'll talk something else.
We'll have the longer conversation later. I'll let them get that paint finished before it starts snowing. Next we have, we're done with you, Mr. Rockwell. Next, we have Resolution 152031, a resolution waiving the formal bid process and awarding the construction of the RHS V&A Water Main Replacement Project to JSR Barrico Co. Mr. Zabrocki, please.
Thank you, Mayor and Board. What's before you tonight, three proposals were accepted to reroute a water main down on the Romeoville High School property. You've all seen the V&A facility that's been going up there. The water main wasn't quite where everybody had thought it was. So what's before you, and there's some sketches, I think, in the documents that you guys have looked at, kind of showing where it was and where we want to reroute it, and then ultimately hook it up back into the V&A system. So three proposals were requested. that information is in there as well. The low is J.S. Albarico, who's done work for the village numerous times, and we'd ask that you approve that proposal.
Very good. Any questions or comments? Trustee McClevitt?
Just real quick, all three of the proposals are from companies, firms, whatever, that we've worked with before. We're comfortable with all three of them. J.S. Albarico just happened to be the lowest proposal, whatever, right?
That is correct.
All right, thank you.
Very good. Any other questions or comments? Hearing none, we'll go to the next one, which is Resolution 152030, Resolution Authorizing a Redevelopment Agreement for the downtown McDonald's. Rich Vogel, please.
Thanks, Your Honor. This is relevant to the new McDonald's on Route 53. It's in the downtown TIF district, and McDonald's in the village had for some time discussed a redevelopment agreement to provide a little bit of assistance for developing a piece of property that, you know, had some challenges to it. And so what the agreement provides for is that the village, through the tax increment generated by the project, will reimburse up to $100,000 to McDonald's for expenses, TIF eligible expenses associated with the project.
Very good. Yeah, and I think we just, timing on trying to get this done a lot, but you know, a very challenging site, had a lot of extra unique challenges. This is just a little bit to offset some of the public improvement things that needed to happen. And I think they have another school over there. Didn't you say which school is it? One of the bands is over there tonight, isn't there?
Locantic Middle School is there tonight for their McTeacher Night.
For their McTeacher Night? And then I agree, King. They said they could almost, they're taunting Chief that they had maybe too many kids from Irene King.
Yeah, apparently the entire school showed up for that one last Wednesday.
Well, it is very good to see them reaching out so early to the community. Any questions or comments on this one? Trustee McClevitt, please.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Just again, a clarification. The way that was written in talks about that can be made in any year during the agreement. Is this a one-time or is this over multiple years?
It's a cumulative total payment of $100,000.
Okay.
Annually.
So, yeah. Again, clarification. It's annual, cumulative. It could be $10,000 one year, whatever,
yeah,
up to $100,000 over X number of years.
Refers to 50% of the additional tax revenue, the increment generated by the project, up to half of that collected in a particular year. That's the maximum reimbursement in any calendar year that they can get relative to the project. $100,000 is the lifetime total,
sure.
No matter, you know, how it gets divvied up over the years during the life of the project, they can't ever collect more than that sum of money in total.
Thank you, because I wasn't sure if it's $100,000 a year for
eternity
or what it was, so the cap is $100,000.
Once the $100,000 is collected, essentially this is of no further effect.
And again, that's why we have TIF districts for just this purpose, to get a business going in an area that, but for, would not be there. So it's exactly what we have.
Type of application.
Okay, great. Thank you.
Trisha Richards, did you have something?
Just a quick, to add on to that, so the open-ended agreement is simply because we don't know how much tax revenue is going to be generated. We can't put a date on it, so it's open-ended until that $100,000 is gone.
It's easier to put a dollar cap
right.
than a year cap.
Right. Exactly.
For that very reason.
Yes. Yes.
We've had similar agreements where I think more in sales tax type agreements, and we've put both the dollar limitation and the time limitation on it. And in at least two instances that I can think of, we've come back and either amended or entirely removed the time limitation because ultimately it turned out to be inconsistent with what the village actually wanted to do. I think that same philosophy kind of comes into play here.
Very good. And I think just kind of go off of Trustee McClevitt's comments on it, which is this is TIF revenue, new TIF revenue, and it's sharing a portion of it not to exceed that total amount. So, and once the final assessment and valuation of the site is determined by the assessor, then we'll know kind of what that's going to be. So, very good. Any other questions or comments? But very good to point that out. So. Resolution 152032, resolution authorizing execution of an intergovernmental agreement between the village of Romeoville and Lockport Township for the purpose of operation of an outdoor warning sign system. Rich?
Thanks, Your Honor. This is just something where we're going to take over through REMA the operation, the triggering of a warning siren that's located in College U. It just makes a lot more sense from a practical standpoint because it's, you know, it's sort of within our, you know, zone where we activate sirens. It's really not, it doesn't make any sense for Lockport to keep doing it when it's closer to us than it is to, you know, the bulk of Lockport. We think that doing this will ultimately provide better warning to everybody in the area and kind of eliminate confusion.
Very good. It sounds like a good or a good way to do it, and I'm sure it'll help out. We know that Mr. Chell and his team do an excellent job, so very good. It's a good way to work together. Any questions, comments?
I have a question.
Sure.
How old is that? Because I know we've done some upgrades here. How old is their sign?
I believe that one's in the late 90s.
Late 90s?
We have one that are older.
All right, go ahead. Thank you.
Yeah, there's some comments, please.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. And I didn't see you over there, Mr. Latrell. I thought I saw you earlier in the back, and I didn't see you. This is something that you want and you feel is best for REMA and everything to have control, so to speak, of this, and this is one of your recommendations then?
Yeah, we've been trying to work this for a couple years.
Okay.
Just a matter of getting the IGA set up between the two entities. Okay.
Very good. Thank you.
Very good. Some nice intergovernmental cooperation. We'd like to see that. So hopefully it works out and safer for everybody and works better. So, any other further comments or questions? Hearing none, I'll entertain a motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Second. Motion by Trustee Chavez, second by Trustee Griffin. Any further discussion? Hearing none, can I get a roll call, please?
I'm sorry, Mayor, who was it?
Chavez and Griffin.
Thank you. Trustee Chavez?
Aye.
Trustee Griffin?
Aye.
Trustee Pallmeyer?
Aye.
Trustee Clancy?
Aye.
Trustee Richards?
Aye.
Trustee McCrevin?
Aye.
Motion carried.
Very good. We will move right into the regular meeting of the Village of Romeoville. It's Wednesday, October 21st, 2015 at 6:45 p.m. Can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Pallmeyer?
Here.
Trustee Chavez?
Here.
Trustee Clancy?
Here.
Trustee Richards?
Here.
Trustee McCrevitz?
Here.
Trustee Griffin?
Here.
Mayor Noak?
Here.
We have a quorum.
Very good. Trustee Pallmeyer with leads from the pledge.
Thank you, Mayor. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Very good. Petitions from public?
Mayor, it's hard to tell if someone started to write and decided not to. Okay. So do we have any petitioners tonight?
Okay. Very good. We have no petitions from public, and then we'll move on for consent agenda.
So moved.
Second.
Motion for consent agenda by Trustee Griffin, second by Trustee Clancy. Any further discussions? Hearing none, can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Griffin?
Aye.
Trustee Clancy?
Aye.
Trustee Pallmeyer?
Aye.
Trustee Chavez?
Aye.
Trustee Richards?
Aye.
Trustee McClevitt?
Aye.
Motion carried.
Very good. Within that consent agenda, we have the minutes 150596, approval of minutes October 5th, 2015 workshop meeting. Minutes 150597, approval of minutes October 5th, 2015 regular meeting. 152118, approval of bill schedule A. 152119, approval of bill schedule B. 152120, approval of bill schedule C. 152121, approval of bill schedule D. Resolution 152033, resolution approving a contract with Neil Gerber and Essenberg LLP. Resolution 152034, resolution establishing development security covering the public improvements, erosion and sediment controls measures for the President's health facility. Resolution 152035, resolution authorizing waiving the bids and awarding a contract to Kelmscott Communications for the Recreation Department brochure printing. And resolution 152036, resolution authorizing waiving the bids and awarding a contract to Melrose Pyrotechnics Inc. Fireworks.
So moved.
Motion by Trustee Griffin.
Second.
Second by Trustee Richards. Any further discussion? Hearing that, can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Griffin?
Aye.
Trustee Richards?
Aye.
Trustee Pallmeyer?
Aye.
Trustee Chavez?
Aye.
Trustee Clancy?
Aye.
And Trustee McClevitz?
Aye.
Motion carried.
Very good. Mayor's report. I'm going to start my part out tonight with a big new announcement. It's starting to get out there a little bit, so and it'll be on planning and zoning next week. So we're going to go ahead and let everybody know tonight. We got it cleared with the Blaine family, but We are announcing that Blaine's Farm and Fleet will be purchasing and building, the Blaine family will be purchasing the remaining corner at Airport and Weber on the southeast corner. They will be building a new generation of store at this location. It will be their first store in Will County. The store will be approximately 122,000 square feet. They are purchasing a 29-acre parcel, and we are very excited. We were just met with the Blaines. We got an extra copy here. We just met with the Blaines at the shopping center conference in Chicago the previous week, and finalized some of our details. It will be coming. The first concept plans will be coming before planning and zoning next week, before the board following meeting, and they have a very aggressive timeline, and very excited. A whole new way of approaching their product and their line, so we're excited to have it and be the first of this whole new generation of store for the family. I think they have currently, what do we say, there's seven outlots that they're going to be developing as along with it, seven retail outlots as part of the project, and this they already have, this will be their 37th store, I believe. So very excited. It's a new endeavor, something different, something we don't have. They'll be doing a lot of home improvement, a lot of landscaping, stuff like that, that currently is not real. We don't have really a heavy component of here in our community. So it's very exciting news. We're excited to have the Blaines coming. We'll be talking more about this, but we decided to go ahead and let everybody know. So we do have a press release for any members of the press that would like a copy of it, and some of the renderings of the new store concept that they will be unveiling. So very exciting news. Corner, a lot of people have been asking about for a while now. Continues to show, along with the projects we talked about and the growth in some of the companies that we have here tonight, that and some, many of which have come to our community over the last couple of years, and some that are doing new things. How exciting our market really continues to be. This is a great new addition, in addition to some of the other things that are happening. I can see the folks from Presence shaking their heads going, that's great. We got a whole lot of activity happening on that corner. In addition to the Continental Apartments, which broke ground just this last week as well. A lot of activity in the quarter, so I'm sure everybody will be very happy about that. So so some good news tonight, in addition to everything else we're doing. Also want to thank everybody came out to the fire department open house. Also want to thank Congressman Pinsky inviting me to a roundtable with many of my colleagues in his district, and talked about many important topics to communities that on the federal level the other week. Also want to congratulate Rasmussen. They had a special ribbon cutting on a new surgical technician lab, which is great. We had a great costume ball the other last weekend, and a lot of great costumes out there. So wonderful turnout. Anybody that hasn't seen the pictures, you got to check out Steve Caton as Buddy the Elf. It really was quite the quite the impressive costume, right up there with some of Ken's previous costumes. McDonald's had their official ribbon cutting on Route 53 across from the Athletic and Events Center this past week. We will be, as we've kind of alluding to, Presence will be hosting their groundbreaking on the new facility, barring that we pass it, this Friday at 10:30. So we're excited about that. Halloween Fest will be this Friday at 6 o'clock at the Recreation Center grounds. Just a lot of excitement. Another note too, Misswood Golf Club is approaching completion of the new banquet facility and restaurant. Well, many of us were out visiting it the other night. They will be announcing a formal grand opening a grand opening date to the public probably sometime in early November, in the first half of November. It's just an amazing facility for everybody. Everybody should be very proud of it as well. New banquet facility that can hold 300 for a more open format, maybe 250 in that range for a wedding. Brand new restaurant, new pro shop. It's just an amazing facility to see. Great architecture. It's one of a kind. We'll be having that opening here shortly as well. So a lot happening in the community. Now, everybody have a happy and safe Halloween. I'll be out there with my little guy, and who knows what one of his many costumes he will wear. I'm sure we'll probably go through a few. So we'll be out there at all these Halloween events, but be safe. There's lots of opportunity to bring kids out, not only our Halloween event, a lot of the Park District have events. Rasmussen has an event, High Point has events, Trunk or Treats, Brie. There's lots of opportunities to take the kids out in very safe environments. So please, I know the village has sent out a list of a lot of them, so take advantage of all these safe opportunities for the kids. And then let's all get excited about seeing our new endeavor by the Mullane family. We're excited to have them join us. So, clerk's report.
Thank you, Mayor Noak. I don't have a report tonight. The Community Service Council canceled the meeting for October.
Very good. Citizens Commission's Commission reports to my baseball friends. Wanna?
I'll pass.
I'll leave it up to you. Do I got a general nod? Do you want to save these for maybe the next one? Or?
Yeah, I'd like to save
include
that.
Your important stuff.
Yeah. One I need to
all right, we'll accelerate. Trustee Chavez. Fire and Police, was Romeoville
no
TV?
Update today, sir.
There you go. Trustee Fallmeiter, Finance, Humane Society, Special Event?
No, I've been absent, so I pass.
Very good. Trustee Griffin, Veterans Commission and EZ.
Just a quickie for all you veterans out there. You're going to get fed for free Saturday the 7th of November from 12 until 2 o'clock at 55 Phelps Avenue. It's sponsored by the Romeoville Veterans Commission. You need to contact the village Chris Beninio at 815-823-3907. If you leave a message, please spell your name. You need to call to RSVP just to make sure they have enough food. That's it.
Very good. Trustee Clancy, Beautification, Parks and Rec.
Just keep it real short. The awards banquet for the beautification went over well. A lot of people were very happy with what they won and received. And the one important thing, October 23rd, as the mayor mentioned, for the Halloween, there will be 400 pumpkins given to the first 400 children that show up, so that'll encourage people to get out there. Thank you.
Very good. Trustee Richards, Planning and Zoning, Zoning Board of Appeals, REMA. I know I stole one of your big ones.
You did, yes. That's okay. Yes, Planning and Zoning will be reviewing the concept for Blaine's Farm and Fleet, which is very exciting news. They will also be looking at annexation and zoning of 330 acres of Will County Forest Preserve property along 135th Street. So a lot more happening on that in that 53 corridor area as well going forward. No update for REMA.
Very good. You know, as you mentioned the Forest Preserve, you reminded me too, we did put out another press release. We were notified and a final approval of the new trail grant through CMAT that is part of that will help interconnect our trail system, a major announcement for about a $1.3 million grant that we just announced today that we will be receiving in federal funds. So, Trustee McClippett, please.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Real quick, the Mayor already alluded to the costume ball, and that is actually a fundraiser. It's one of the major fundraisers for the Romeoville Youth Outreach Commission, and they did raise over $700. That money will go back into the funds for the scholarships for the youth. So again, it was successful on many fronts. Everybody there had a great time, and it actually raised money that's going to go back to the community. And that's all I have tonight.
Very good. Great costumes, and people are really impressive. Village manager report.
No report.
There you go. I thought what another Cubs fan in the crowd. New business.
I move for a consent agenda with the exception of ordinance 15-1220.
Okay, very good. All right, I got a motion to consent agenda except for ordinance 15-1220. We'll take that one separately. Second by Trustee Chavez. Motion by Trustee Griffin, second by Trustee Chavez. Any further discussion? Hearing none, can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Griffin.
Aye.
Trustee Chavez.
Aye.
Trustee Pallmeyer.
Aye.
Trustee Clancy.
Aye.
Trustee Richards.
Aye.
And Trustee McClevitz.
Aye.
Motion carried.
Very Very good. Within that consent agenda for new business, we have ordinance 151219, ordinance approving a variance for a zoning ordinance regarding signage for Megan Glove and Safety Manufacturing Company, ordinance 151222, ordinance approving a special use permit for a planned unit development for present senior health carts pavilion on outlot 10 of Romeoville Crossing, ordinance 151223, ordinance approving a rezoning of territory to P1, public-private land conservation district for the old Village Hall site, ordinance 151224, ordinance approving a minor amendment to a special use permit for a planned unit development for Brunswick Zone at 735 North Central Boulevard, resolution, which is just painting, resolution 152030, resolution authorizing a redevelopment agreement for the downtown McDonald's on Route 53, resolution 152031, resolution waiving the formal bid process and awarding construction of the RHS VNA water main replacement project to JS Aberco Company. Resolution 152032, resolution authorizing execution of an intergovernmental agreement between the Village of Romeoville and Blackport Township for the purpose of operation of an outdoor warning siren system.
So moved.
Motion to approve by Trustee Griffin.
Second.
Second by Trustee Clancy. Any further discussion? Hearing none, can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Griffin.
Aye.
Trustee Clancy.
Aye.
Trustee Palmer.
Aye.
Trustee Chavez.
Aye.
Trustee Richards.
Aye.
Trustee McClellan.
Aye.
Motion carried.
Very good. We have a motion by ordinance 151220.
So moved.
Motion to second. Approve as submitted by the company for the 35-foot
yes.
Clarification. Yes. I got a motion by Trustee Griffin. I got a second by Trustee Chavez. Further discussion? Hearing none, can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Griffin.
No.
Trustee Chavez.
Yes.
Trustee Palmer.
No.
Trustee Clancy.
Yes.
Trustee Richards.
Yes.
Trustee McClevitz.
No.
Oh, Mayor Noak.
Yes.
Motion carried.
Fails. Yes, that's super. The other variation does not require a board approval because it meets code. Motion. Do you want to take a moment to discuss with the applicant? Okay. You got a motion to that effect by Trustee Griffin to reconsider. Do we have a second?
I'll second, but I just want to confirm that is to follow the code then.
You're making the motion to reconsider, which has the effect of sort of rolling back the vote that you just took. Once you do that, what I would suggest is that somebody make a motion
okay. I second that then.
Very good. So now we got a second of motion. Any further discussion before the reconsideration? Can I get a roll call for that?
Trustee Griffin.
Aye.
Trustee McClevitz.
Aye.
Trustee Palmer.
Aye.
Trustee Chavez.
Aye.
Trustee Clancy.
Aye.
Trustee Richards.
Aye.
Motion carried.
I'd like to move that we, help me wordsmith this, that we reconsider the motion to put it in compliance with our existing ordinances.
I'd like to move to adopt an ordinance approving the signage application amended to reflect the 40-foot tall 10x10 sign in compliance with Village Code.
What he just said.
Yes. And I'll second that.
And motion by Trustee Griffin, second by Trustee Palminer. Any further discussion? Hearing none, can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Griffin.
Aye.
Trustee Palminer.
Aye.
Trustee Chavez.
Aye.
Trustee Clancy.
Aye.
Trustee Richards.
Aye.
Trustee McCrevitt.
Aye.
Motion carried.
Very good. Now we have board comments. Trustee Schvetz, please.
Just want to say have a safe Halloween for all the kids. Please be careful with the kids walking out there, and hopefully we get a victory tonight. That's all I have, Mayor.
Very good. Trustee Pallmeyer, please.
What he said.
Very good. Trustee Griffin, please.
What she said.
Very good. Trustee Clancy.
Basically, passing it on, let's hope they get four in a row if everybody knows what we're talking about. Thank you.
Very good. Trustee Richard, please.
Just a couple of quick things, and I will be brief. I want to congratulate Hermanson Elementary School on their successful reading night and book fair the other night. I had a great time out there reading to a bunch of our young children from the area. And I want to remind everyone, last home football games is Friday night. They've had a tough season, but they could definitely use some support out there on senior night. So if you're looking for something new Friday night, go see that RHS football game. That's all I have.
Very good. Trustee McClevitz, please.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I wanted to congratulate Rasmussen College for celebrating, I believe it's 115 years. That's fantastic. Yeah. Congratulations and welcome to the new McDonald's. I did want to mention also that the our very own Special Recreation Association is having a Trivia Craze fundraiser on Saturday, November 7th. The fundraisers are always a lot of fun, the Trivia Craze fundraisers. And the great thing about this is it goes right back into this community to help people who have special needs and disabilities. So if you're available to get a team together for the Trivia Craze fundraiser on November 7th, you can probably contact the Romeoville Recreation Department. They'll have more information for you. And again, to reiterate what the mayor said earlier, there's several, I mean several, opportunities for Halloween fun. There's the Halloween Fest on October 23rd right here. There's Fun Frights by Firelight. That's also on October 23rd at the Isle a la Cache Museum. There's a Trunk or Treat at the Friendship Square on Saturday, October 24th. The Romeoville High School is having a Trunk or Treat on Sunday, October 25th. White Oak Library has a Family Fun Party on Thursday, October 29th. And Rasmussen College is having a Halloween Fest on Friday, October 30th. So if you can't find fun on Halloween, then you're not looking in the right spot. And I also wanted to congratulate the village on the CMAP funding for the bike trail or multi-use trail. I think that's absolutely fantastic. And other than that, everybody have a safe and happy Halloween. Thank you.
Very good. We don't have an executive session, so I'll entertain a motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Motion by Trustee Griffin, second by Trustee Clancy. Any further discussion? Hearing none, can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Griffin.
Aye.
Trustee Clancy.
Aye.
Trustee Pallmeyer.
Aye.
Trustee Chavez.
Aye.
Trustee Richards.
Aye.
And Trustee McClevitz.
Aye.
Motion carried.
Well, and good night, and good luck to all those fans out there.